capital of Georgia at our location tonight. Welcome, everyone, to Game 3 of the Eastern Conference quarterfinals. We're all tied at 1-1. If the first two games have been any indication, we should be in for a great series. This is Kevin Harlan along with Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. Great to have you with us. It's Indiana taking on the Atlanta Hawks. A quick check now at the starting lineups for both teams. And guys, taking a look at Paul George, what will we see from him?
Well, he's an exciting young player. Almost 6'10", great athleticism, length, and a dynamic finisher at the rim, and you can guard multiple positions defensively.
And you know what, Steve? His growth defensively has been just as impressive. He uses that length to great advantage, contesting shots and coming away with deflections and steals.
Take a look at the Hawks. They managed to take one game on the road. Now the challenge to take care of business on their home court.
Well, being on the road for the first two games, realistically, you're hoping for a split. So I'm sure they're happy with where they stand right now. They've stolen home court advantage, and now they just need to hang on to it.
Yeah, Steve, that's easier talked than walked. Despite getting that split, I still have them as the underdog in this series. And it's a very good team they're up against, and they're not just going to roll over either.
The Pacers shooting their first free throw of the game here. On defense, Indiana. It's a three-point game. We're feeling confident after Tuesday's big win.
And what that game came down to, guys, was their ability to use that three-point shot so effectively.
The work they did on the perimeter was absolutely outstanding. Way too much for that defense to be able to handle.
Five on the clock. It's stolen by Hill. Stevenson dishes to George. The shot, no good. So Atlanta will take it the other way. Here is Korver. He's guarded by Stevenson. Korver passes to Antic. That is good.
You gotta love the low post offense. That was beautiful.
And it's the Pacers with the ball. Hill kicks to Stevenson. And Damari Carroll is gonna pick up the foul. Here in the first, a little over a minute played so far. And here's George for three. Atlanta with the rebound. Korver off the pick from Millsap. Team left side. From the high post. Misses off the right iron.
And a missed opportunity right there.
Definitely. I think he should have converted that one.
Outside Hill. This one for three. Hits the bucket. Good. Hill's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball.
They really can't allow him too many open looks like that. I mean, that's just inviting trouble.
Teague against Hill. Teague, the pass to Antic. And that comes off the assist by Jeff Teague.
Great interplay there between those two teammates.
Pacers have gone 2-for-4 from the field so far today. Hill drives in. Last inside. Rejected by Millsap. Out of bounds. Pacers ball is Indiana keeps possession. This is the list of the NBA's theft leaders during the regular year. Fifth best, Paul George.
You know what, Kevin? I wonder how many times this year an opposing coach has said, protect the ball. When this guy's on the floor, he's really been a defensive force.
Now, here is Hill. The dish now to West. Over Millsap. West, that's good. If you're just tuning in, we've played about 2.5 minutes here in the first. Teague gets a screen from Antic. Teague can't hit. Pacers leading by 4. George dishes to Hill. Back to George. Indiana moving the ball over. Hill kicks to Stevenson. Hill sets the screen for West. Good. West has got his second bucket of the night.
They can't afford to give him that kind of look.
Well, it came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you got to fight over the top of that.
Now here's Millsap. Carroll passes to Teague. He dishes it to Carroll. Inside. Korver kicks to Millsap. That's good.
They're really doing a nice job establishing the presence inside early.
That's going to open things up for them on the perimeter going forward.
Just under 3.5 minutes gone here in the first quarter. And it's Hill penetrating outside Jordan. Good. The assist goes to Hill.
Wow, just a tremendous first quarter shooting the basketball for them, guys.
Yeah, when they put it up, it's gone in.
The Hawks trail by 6. Here is Korver. The feed now to Millsap. And that's off the glass and in. Millsap's got his second best.
The mid-range jumper becomes a high percentage shot for him when he has that kind of space.
Hill up top. Teague covering. Hill misses to West. 13 feet away. Rebound by the Hawks. Korver's got 3 rebounds now in this one. Pass to Antic. Feeds it to Korver. Dishes it to T. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Let's go. Again, the Hawks good for 2. The Pacers have gone 5-9 from the field here in the first. Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Mike Budenholzer and I got a chance to talk for a bit. Stealing a win on the road was huge for them, but coach said that protecting their home court is an even bigger issue. And to do that, he says the key is aggressive defense. As he put it, we want to prevent them from getting into any kind of comfort zone at our end of the floor. Guys, back to you.
Thank you, Doris. And Indiana making a change here. Mahimi's checked in for Hibbert. Scola comes in for West. Evan Turner, he's checked in for George. And it's Watson in for Hill. Now here's Scola. And here's Stevenson. Back to Scola. And the shot is good. Scola's got his first basket of the night.
Unselfish basketball on the interior. I love that, and you got to think the coaching staff does, too.
It's Williams with the drive. He feeds it to Mack. Carroll for 3, and he gets the bucket. Carroll's got himself on the board with 3 there.
I'm not sure that was the play they had set up, but it was too good a look to pass it.
41 seconds left in the first quarter of the game. Outside Turner, out to the right wing. Five to shoot. Stevenson can't hit.
Well, he won't miss many of those, especially with the defender not in the best of positions yet.
Carroll kicks to Williams. Another 3 for Atlanta.
Excellent ball movement there, guys.
Yeah, I think that's what's keyed this run, Park, because they're keeping the ball moving. Defense hasn't been able to set up.
There's a good screen. Stevenson kicks to Scola. Fires the jumper from the corner and nails it.
What a start to this game. The offense is both dominated.
Tell you what, feels like a game on the playground. Forget about defense. Just keep firing.
Williams. And it would have counted had it fallen, but it's offline.
Western Conference, Round 1. Kevin Durant and the Oklahoma City Thunder go on the road to battle the Memphis Grizzlies. This weekend, NBA action.
This game, solid offense. They got good ball movement. They established a nice rhythm.
Yeah, not stagnant at all. Free-flowing and fluid at the offensive end.
And a chance here presented by Gatorade to see who's on the floor, all fueled up and ready to go for the start of the second quarter. On the court right now for the Hawks, Sheldon Mack is out there with Lou Williams. Then it's Mike Scott. Then it's Elton Brand. And it's Carroll. And at the 3, the small forward.
That's pretty much been the norm for them, getting their points off assists and great ball movement.
Nice rhythm and flow for this team. Tremendous communication and alertness.
Now here's Stevenson. In low to Scola. to the right side. Stevenson passes to Scope. Outside Turner. Here the step back. Shot is off. And it's the Hawks taking it the other way. Quarter number two. We're about a minute in. On the wing, Williams. Fires from deep. Another shot. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him. Well, we've got a chance. Let's now take a look at the regular season's slickest passing teams. The Hawks second.
You know, sometimes it's tough to give up the ball to a teammate, but the good teams do it. They don't settle for just a good shot. They're looking for the best shot. And these guys have been unselfish all season long.
First one falls for him. Some changes for Indiana. Roy Hibbert's checked in for Mahini. West comes in for Luis Scola. And it's George in for Lance Stevenson. So Brand nails both of them. Just over a minute gone here in the second quarter. Teague against Hill. The pass to George. Here's Hibbert. Shot is no good. Great D that time from Brand. It's Williams with the drive. Hill with some nice D. Pacers trail by four. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, I mean, cold stretch offensively. They desperately need a basket.
And George picks it to West. Inside the Hibbert. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Yeah, when he's not blocking shots, he's altering them, Kevin, because he's just a constant presence and a threat defensively in the paint.
And he can wipe that offensive glass too, Steve. I mean, he turns a whole lot of misses into makes.
That free throw missing. Atlanta making a switch here. The second free throw, good. Teague with the ball. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. And he gets it to go. Second quarter of play with around 2 minutes gone so far. Outside West. Side West. It's rebounded by Antic.
The defense better not make a habit of giving him that shot. I mean, he doesn't miss many of them. Here it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established great position inside.
Yeah, getting the ball into the post should be their first option every time down. Force the defense to adapt and adjust.
Now here's Teague. Rocket six. Millsap. That's good. And so Teague with the assist. Millsap's got the lead back up to five now for Atlanta. For Indiana, they've gotten only one of their first four shots in the second quarter to drop. Tries it from 19. West misses.
I think the game plan needs to change here, guys, if they're going to get out of the hole, because he is not helping their offense.
And it's going to be out of bounds. The Pacers will take it.
16 seconds.
And so it's Indiana with it, trailing by five. And the Pacers call time here. let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
I was able to listen in on what Frank Vogel had to say to his team. It's their perimeter defense that had him pretty wound up. He told his guys to be conscious of ball movement away from the hoop and be sure to always have their hands up when the shot is taken. He also wants them to play very physically. Impose your will on them, he said. Let them know who they're up against. So, Kevin, change is already being made on the fly here in the second quarter.
Thank you, Doris. Here's Teague. Paul George making his last shot. And now the first timeout called here for the Hawks.
He did not look too happy about some of the things he saw on the court. So I would expect some changes here.
I think it's the right move, quite honestly. I mean, they just didn't look sharp or at their best out there. So take the timeout and give yourself a chance to regroup.
And we've got a chance here to look at the small forward position and how these players stack up in terms of their free throw shooting during the regular season. Second is Paul George.
Well, there are some smooth strokes among that group, guys. What else can you say?
As a coach, you want your small forwards to be aggressive in getting to the basket. I mean, that's a must. And with these players, whether they draw the foul or get a layup out of it, it's a win-win.
And in the second quarter, a little under 3.5 minutes played already. Williams attacking. And the basket good. Williams has got 5.
Took advantage of some shoddy defense there. They've got to at least get a finger on it.
Out to the wing. Here's West. And the Pacers tack on 2 more. So it's Atlanta now. 3-point lead. Millsap a screen on Turner. For 3, Williams, but he stays with it. Here's Hauntic. For Indiana, they've gone 3-7 shooting the ball here in the second quarter. Tries to save it. Teague against Turner. A floater. And the layup drops in from Jeff Teague. Teague's got the lead up to 5 now for the Hawks. Pacers shooting around 43% from the floor in the second quarter. George dishes to Turner. Hill passes to Turner. And George kicks to Turner. T2 from Hill. Nails the wide open jump shot. Hill's got 5. Here's Teague. 1:10 left here in the second. Pass to court. Shot clock at 6. Good on the 3-point shot. Korver's got his second basket of the game.
Well, you can't leave him alone, especially from long range.
Hill kicks to Turner. West against Millsap. West dishes to Hill. Outside, George. And right away, they match it with a 3-pointer of their own. He has 7.
Boy, he's really doing a nice job taking advantage of what the defense is giving.
We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Williams passes to Millsap. To Hauntic. The shot from the low post is good. And the Hawks lead by 5. 15 seconds left now here in the second. Teague against Hill. Outside, George with 4 seconds on the clock. Good, and it's Hill picking up the assist. 9 points here for George.
You know, he'll make you scratch your head and throw your hands up as a defender. I mean, you just don't know how to play.
Close game as we wrap up the second quarter. Hawks lead by 3. And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Kevin, thank you. Roy, I know you have just a couple seconds, but in a nutshell, what's going to be your approach going into the second half?
Well, we're just going to make sure we keep them off the board and keep them out of transition.
Thank you, Roy. Kevin, over to you.
Thank you, Doris, and we'll be back for the third quarter of action following halftime.
Now, presented by Sprint.
What unbelievable postseason action we've got going on so far. This is 2K Sports as we get deeper into round one of the playoffs. Out at Phillips Arena, the Hawks have the lead against Indiana. They're looking to get back to their winning ways in today's game and work a 2-1 lead in this series. Paul Millsap making an impact in this one, and they love the output they've gotten out of Lewis Williams, too. And no shortage of desire from the Pacers side of things. Garbage points making up the difference, and right now they're sweeping the streets. The first half, a productive one for George Hill. He's got 5 points, and he's been able to provide some nice assists as well. And around the league we go, plenty of NBA playoff action going on. Out in Memphis, it'll be the Grizzlies against the Thunder. That series currently locked up at one win apiece. 8 p.m. Eastern, that one gets started. And the other game tipping off later, the Los Angeles Clippers up against the Warriors out in Oakland. That series currently locked up at one win apiece. Start of the game is 10:30 Eastern, 7:30 Pacific. That's it for me here in the studio. Time to send you back out to Kevin Harlan and the crew for the start of the third quarter.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
He's one of those players who can get hot and stay hot from the three-point line, so I look for him to continue to search for shots out there.
On the court for Indiana, Paul George is the three with David West at the four. At the one and two, George Hill and Lance Stevenson. And it's Hibbert in at the center, filling out the middle. Millsap misses. Pacers trail by three. Stevenson kicks to Hill. Inside to Hibbert. Good, and it's Hill picking up the assist. Hill's got 4 assists in the game.
Textbook right there. Nice pass, great catch, beautiful finish.
Now here's Teague. Kicks it to Pierce. Paul George with the steal. And now the fast break, George with the ball. And the basket by Hill.
That's their third straight make off an assist.
Boy, the ball movement's been fantastic here the last few possessions.
Teague gets a screen from Millsap. Teague with the ball. George picks him up. Teague kicks to Korver. Here's Antic, and fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. Roy Hibbert picks one up. You can see the leadership qualities on display right there, guys.
It's all about communication, Kevin. You can't have too much of that as a team, and he's really leading, trying to gather his guys together.
Clark?
Well, I agree with all of that. I mean, when you're talking about orchestrating your offense and defense, that requires a lot of communication, understanding where people need to be and what everybody is doing right. And if mistakes are being made, those things have to be pointed out as well.
Mahimi's checked in for Indiana. Is no good. Indiana leading. Stevenson with it. Now guarded by Antic. Stevenson dishes to West. Again, Indiana.
Boy, guys, they've shown some great passing on their last few trips now on the floor. Excellent.
Yeah, that's 4 straight trips, guys, where their passes have ended up in scores. 4 straight assists. Great team play.
Now here's Teague. The three from Korver. David West grabs the miss.
Boy, but he was close, Kevin, to making the defense pay for lackadaisical coverage there.
Yeah, he had a really good look. He would not sat down so often enough.
Here is Stevenson. Gets back to Hill. Indiana moving it around. Two open that time. Made it look too easy. Now it's a 6-point Pacer lead.
Well, it's been a great start for this offense here in the second half. 4 for 4.
Time call here. The Hawks decide to talk it over.
Yeah, he's trying to take the wind out of their sails here. I mean, they're on the wrong end of a bad run. They got to sort things out.
I think things were very close to spiraling out of control if he didn't burn one there.
I think Doris Burke has something for us right now. Doris?
Hi, guys. I had a chance to find out what Mike Budenholzer was discussing with his guys. He was going over the specifics of their defensive game plan against Paul George. With the damage he's been inflicting, coach said that every man on the floor has got to be aware of where he is at all times, so saying, quote, one-on-one defense is not going to get it done against him today. You've got to help each other out. Those could prove to be crucial changes to their strategy with this game getting ready to enter the stretch drive, Kevin.
All right, Doris. Second half of play with just under 2.5 minutes gone. Hill kicks to Stevenson. Outside, George, pass to Scola. The turnaround jumper, and again it's Indiana converting.
I'm waiting for the fire alarm to go off the way they've come out blazing in the second half. That's 5 straight makes.
T kicks to Brand. And that comes off the assist by Jeff Teague. Teague's got his 3rd assist on the night.
Very clever passing. That was just beautifully done.
Outside Hill. He kicks it to Scola. Here is Mahini. There's the dish to Scola. 6 to shoot. And it comes off the front of the rim. The Hawks trail by 4. Third quarter of basketball here in just a little under 3.5 minutes gone by. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him. Well, looking back at the regular season now at the leaderboard of the highest scoring small forwards. These guys putting up the offense trying to get their teams to the playoffs. The 4th spot held by Paul George.
Those are some tremendous athletes as we're used to seeing at that spot on the floor. You know, they can pretty much all give phenomenal individual performances on any given night.
And most nights, that's exactly what they do. Every team wants and needs scoring from the small forward position. And all of the players on that list provide it.
C.J. Watson, he's checked in for the Pacers. And so Brand nails both of them. Pacers have gone 5 of 6 so far from the field in the second half. Tremendous efficiency. Here is Watson. Teague covering. Stevenson off the pick for Mahini. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot 2.
Nice work to get inside and draw the foul.
Yeah, it's obvious. The defense not going to allow many easy layups. They're going to make you earn it from the line.
For Indiana, they have made 2 of their previous 3 free throws in today's game. First free throw is good. Williams, he's checked in for Jeff T. So he makes 1 of 2 as the second one misses. The Hawks trail by 3. Williams with the ball. Now defended by Mahini. And Matt kicks to Williams. He dishes it to Matt. Good, and it's Williams who picks up the assist. Max got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. Indiana's gone 3 of 4 from long range in the game. Watson kicks to George. And the shot is good. George has got 5 points in the quarter.
His shooting's been outstanding. Definitely one of the reasons his team is up in this game.
And Mack kicks to Brand. And Williams, here we go. The feed now to Mack. It's Scott on the win. 6 to shoot. Dishes it to Williams. And the shot is good, dropping in off the front of the rim. Williams has got it all tied up now for the Hawks. For Indiana, they've gotten 6 of their 7 shots to go down in this quarter. What a fantastic start to the half. Time called here. Indiana decides to talk it over. And now Doris Burke has an update from the sideline.
Kevin, I was able to hear the advice Frank Vogel gave to his team during that last break. Right away, he said he wants to see better effort on the defensive glass and far fewer second chance opportunities. There's still plenty of basketball left to play, and as we watch how these adjustments play out, Kev, it'll be interesting.
Thanks, Doris. Now, here's Stevenson. 56 seconds left to play here in the third. Six on the shot clock. Turner against Williams. And Brand with the block. And the shot clock expires. 24-second violation.
You cannot afford to make mistakes like that here in a tight game.
Atlanta making a switch here.
Kyle Korver.
Here's Williams. He has seven. Feeds to Brand for the lead. Good. Great play by Williams to set it up. 8 points for Brand.
They're straying away from the three-point game here in the second half. That's fine as long as they're on the lead and they're getting good shots. They decided not to take nearly as many three-pointers in this half.
Now here's Turner. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. Fades. And that one's good. 19 seconds left to play in the third.
Should be the last possession of the quarter if they play it right.
And if their clock management's good, it will be.
Out to the right wing. Here's Mack. Just three on the clock. Off target with that shot. Tie game in Atlanta.
Western Conference, Round 1. The Houston Rockets take on LaMarcus Aldridge and the Portland Trailblazers. Friday night, NBA Hoops. Be there.
Indiana's gone 3-4 from long range in the game. Jeff Teague and Lou Williams, the back. Korver at the three with Paul Millsap at the four. And it's Aldridge in at the five down low. So that's the Hawks five. Now here's Stevenson. Six to shoot. West gets to Turner. Rebound by Williams. Williams has got four rebounds in this game.
You've got to like what they've been doing down there in the low post, Clark.
I do. I love it. Their rebounding has been outstanding. So important in a tight game.
Here's Williams. He feeds it to Korver. Teague against Hill. Nothing there on the wing jumper from Teague. They've been doing a great job of sharing the ball.
Excellent display of team play.
Steve, I know you love great teamwork.
Yeah, so much fun to watch. When the ball is moving, and there's kind of a rhythm to the game that just happens. The ball moves almost on its own. Yeah, it's fun to watch.
And two shots coming up at the line as he gets fouled on the shot. Free throw is good, now leading by one. Mahimi's checked in for Roy Hibbert. And he makes both free throws. A little over a minute of the fourth quarter gone right now. Teague with the ball. Now defended by Mahimi. A nice shot by Teague.
You know, tired legs can affect you at the defensive end, and I think that's what's happening right here.
I agree, because as much offense as we saw early, we're seeing even more of it here late.
Now here's Stevenson. And George kicks to Hill. Indiana moving it around. There's the bucket. Good.
Terrible defense for both teams. Just atrocious.
Yeah, it's been awful, Steve. I don't know any other way to say it, and I'm sure both teams will get an earful from their coaches.
Here is Korver into Millsap. And that's collected by Mahimi.
After fighting back into it, they had a chance to tie this thing up.
Steve, I love it. They are not going away. They brought it close right now.
Now, here is George. The pass to West. Back to George. Passes it to West. Carries it down low. Now it's a four-point Pacer lead. Atlanta's gone 4 of 8 tonight from three-point land, shooting 50% on the three ball here. Korver kicks the tee. All sorts of time. Off the left rim and out.
Most of the time, that shot will go down. Boy, the defenders have to make sure they tag it.
Hill passes to West. It's back to Hill. Just 5 to shoot. Indiana needs to get a shot off. From deep, George. Millsap grabs the miss.
Even against solid defense, he's still going to try to continue to make that shot.
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, I wouldn't bet against him in that situation next time.
Here's Korver for three, and the shot is good.
Those are the types of shots down the stretch that win you ball games, Steve.
The Pacers have gone 2 of 4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. Timeout called, the Pacers. Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
I was able to listen in on what Frank Vogel had to say to his team. He likes how they're playing, so simply said, hey, let's keep it rolling. Let's make the most of it and even this series off. We'll see if they can get the job done, Kevin.
Hill drives in, and that is good. And the Pacers lead by 3.
Well, their plan of attack has been pretty clear to see. Get the ball inside and just take it strong to the hoop. Be dominant in the lane.
Well, the defense has been very slow to adjust. I mean, that's 10 straight points now inside.
Time call here. The Hawks decide to talk it over. Atlanta's gone 5 of 9 when they put up the three-point shot tonight. Millsap sets the pick for T. There's the three. Offensive rebound. That's in, and the Pacer lead is cut down to 1 in the bucket for Millsap.
He got a great read of where that miss was going. That allowed him to be the first guy to it and get the putback.
Pass to George. Shoots a fader. Rebounded by Korver. Korver's got his 5th rebound in this one. Kicks it to Carroll. The dish to Korver to take the lead, and Millsap with the layup.
Ball's a move into the 4th. It's been an even game.
Yeah, it has been. Neither team able to create any significant separation so far.
Steve?
Yeah, that's right, guys. So the lead has now changed hands 5 times.
Now, here is Hill. Pass to George. To the middle. Here's Mahimi. Excellent D there from Arthur. And has gone 1 of 2 from three-point range here in the 4th. Korver dishes to Kira. On 30 left in the 4th. That's good. And now a 3-point Hawks lead.
That was some very sluggish defense. Where's the effort?
Timeout called, the Pacers. They're down by 3. 1:30 left in the game. The Pacers making a switch here. Hibbert's checked in. One 30 left in the 4th. Hill kicks to George. Hibbert inside, guarded by Antic. That's good, and the Atlanta lead is cut down to just one on the basket from Hibbert.
And that shot sucked the life out of the whole building.
Oh, that was a big one, Clark. You can hear it.
Yeah, that was a gut punch right there. These fans, oh, man, they're struggling.
Atlanta calls timeout. They lead by one. 1:19 left to play in the final quarter. Team. 1:10 left in the fourth quarter. He kicks it to Kira. He dishes it to Korver. Frames it from downtown.
Oh, what a clutch shot. That could be the difference maker.
Big, big moment in this game.
Hill kicks to Stevenson. The feed to George. Second shot opportunity, and it's Hibbert missing. Atlanta's gone 6 of 11 when they've taken the three-point shot tonight. Very respectable. Dishes it to Korver. Korver off the pick from Ancic. Korver passes to Teague. And it's sent back by George.
Urgent possession here, Clark. They need a basket.
No doubt about it, Steve. They need quick, efficient scoring.
Here's Stevenson. Here's West. Good work defensively by Milson. And they commit an intentional foul. We'll see another one of those so they can get into the penalty.
Yeah, no question, the right call at this point. You can't let them just dribble it out.
That's right. I mean, you've got to send them to the line and hope for a few misses.
It's stolen by Hill.
Not an easy play to come away with the steal there.
Here comes Teague, and an intentional foul right there. And he cannot get the first one to drop. Tough one to miss. And the second of two is good. That will put them up by two. Timeout called the Pacers. They trail by two. 7 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Hill drives in.
Got it!
And tie game. That is a huge basket right there.
But the drive to the bucket was nice. But how about the finger roll finish? Beautiful.
Time call here. The Hawks decide to talk it over.
Debate on that one.
Yeah, that was as straightforward as it gets, guys.
He sinks the clutch free throw. And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a two-point ball game.
That is delivering in the clutch. Just one more stop is all they need.
And so it's the Hawks who come out on top. And Clark, you know, it was quite a nail bite.
Yeah, it was tight. Their guys were able to come up with big plays down the stretch, and that's the difference.
And a chance now to send you over to Doris Burke, standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Gentlemen, I'm here with Paul Millsap. And Paul, in a game that had its ups and downs, what does it feel like to come out on the winning end of it?
Man, we're just glad we won this game, man. We started off a little sluggish. We started to get our rhythm, get the tempo up, and somehow managed to get this win.
Great win, fighting through adversity early. Guys, back to you.
Thanks, Doris. That'll do it for now for Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for tuning in to the Eastern Conference quarterfinals here on 2K Sports. Now let's check out our Jordan Player of the Game.